Hi Libra, welcome to my channel. This reading for today, Libra, this is a love message. This is a love reading for you, Libra. I hope you are doing well. I hope you're fine and safe and doing good, Libra. This reading for today, this is a love reading. This is a love message for you. What is the guided love message for the Libra sign? What can I get for the Libra friends here? This is a guided love message for the Libra sign. This is the current feelings, current energies. We will be looking into the person that's thinking about you. The person that has a love energy towards you. And you probably also have a love energy towards them, okay? There's some sort of something's connected between the two of you. This is the style or the format of this reading. Okay. Oh, you have an Ace of Cups. Okay. Let's see what's coming towards you guys. Okay. What can I get for the Libra sign? What is the urgent love message for the Libra sign, please? What can they know? I'm seeing 111. Oh, why do you have a Nine of Swords, Libra? And the Knight of Wands. The Devil card. The Justice card. And the Emperor. Okay, let's start the reading, guys. So you have the Nine of Swords and the Sun card and the Knight of Wands. It feels like, Libra, you went to an overthinking in here, the Nine of Swords. It feels like you went to an overanalyzing, an overthinking of a romantic situation. It could be dating, getting to know, Nine of Swords. You've got the Sun card. It feels like you might have overanalyzed, overthinking. You've been thinking about this person almost day and night for some of you before you sleep. It really bothers you that you guys have an issue. Maybe you break up or you guys are not talking right now. But eventually, the Sun card, you realize that this is not a good feeling. You know, something tells me you figure it out that it's not a good feeling to overthink, to overanalyze. Because you've got the Sun card. Look at you. You're very sleepy. It's like you're talking to me and saying, okay, sunshine, I have overthink. I have overanalyzed. Look at me. I am so sleepy. So you realize that it's not comfortable to overthink, to overanalyze. And you're the one who lift yourself up away from the overthinking, away from the overanalyzing in here with the Sun card. Yep, the King of Cups. You realize that you're right, sunshine. And my higher self is talking to me, sunshine. That I shouldn't feel isolated just because this person didn't text me or call me. Or I didn't get a love, you know. I could still get the love from other human being, my friends, my family, the love for myself. I think for now, sunshine, that is enough. The King of Cups, you know. You realize that it was somehow overthinking, overanalyzing. It makes you feel like a burden, like you're creating your own burden. But in this reading, in this vibe, the vibe I'm getting is that you've disciplined yourself. You were able to lift yourself up. You have the Knight of Wands, the last card. The Knight of Wands, it looks like, so be it, you know, the Knight of Wands, yep, I mean, what can I control? The only person and feelings and reaction I can control, sunshine, is myself. So be it, Knight of Wands, if it's not meant to be, it's not meant to be. If they come back, then great, I've got an opportunity to connect and correct my attitude or their attitude. But for now, I want to be the Sun. And I want to be the Knight of Wands. It feels like when you overthink, when you overanalyze, you could not get enough sleep. That it makes you gloomy the whole day. It makes you counterproductive, you know. So you've decided, like, for the sake of my well-being, sunshine, I'm going to lift myself up. You know, the Sun card. Knight of Wands, you could be traveling. You could be, you know, for some of you guys, I'm seeing you don't want to stay too much at home. Or be isolated, and you're keeping yourself busy because the Knight of Wands is very jumpy. Like you're putting your vibe up. You're really making an effort to cheer yourself up, to entertain yourself, to move. Because Knight of Wands, this is movement. As much as possible, you want to keep yourself busy. Maybe you're doing exercise, but there's lots of, this is one of the, I would say the good way to counter overthinking is to move, to keep yourself, your brain busy away from that person or situation that keeps you overthinking. So Knight of Wands, you're putting a lot of effort into, moving, exercising. Let's see. Your Nine of Cups, you could be booking a lot of meeting to your friends, your family, eating, sleeping, drinking. So you're now catching up with life. Okay, you're catching up with sleep, you're catching up with life. You realize that, I don't like that feeling, sunshine. I don't like that feeling of overthinking, overanalyzing. I like the feeling of sitting here, catch up with friends, with family, eat, sleep properly, and then good food, good wine, good company. I mean, life is good, it's so good to be alive, the Knight of Cups. So you figure it out that if love is ready, it will come. If it's not, I don't want to overthink. I don't want to overburden myself. No, sunshine. Okay? Very, very good on you, Libra. Now, the person that made you overthink, the person that you're trying to avoid thinking before, because it just goes to like whenever you access this person, it makes you frustrated or like a dark hole, black hole. Like whenever you go into like a deep thinking of you and this person, you go to a black hole. You're always like stuck. So as much as possible, Nine of Cups, Nine of Wands, moving, living, okay, living, but not overthinking. So the person, okay, the person that made you overthink, overanalyze, they're the devil, And this is the reason why you had an overanalyzing, overthinking, because this is so hard to resist, This is so hard to resist. It's like, it's a feeling of you have a very delicious ice cream in your fridge, but your fridge is locked. You keep knocking on your fridge. Open the fridge. I want to taste the devil, the ice cream. They're the very delicious salted caramel ice cream. So sexy, the devil card. This person made you overthink. Could be a Capricorn, but there's a love and hate relationship in here. There's definitely a lot of unrequited love. This person likes control. In fact, they can feel you, Libra, that they got you in their little finger, Libra. This person enjoys making you wait. This person enjoys making you wait. This person enjoys making love to you out of nothing at all. That's a song, like making love to you, pursuing you and then dropping you. Okay? There's drama with this person. There is manipulative energy. But the thing is, from the Devil card, the Justice card, there's gonna be a huge transition with this person. It feels like you've taught this person a lesson. From the Devil card, you got the card in here, the Justice card. Let's see. Oh, look at that. The Lover's card. I have to cover the ASS. You know what? Let them go. I'm telling you, let them go. They will come back a soulmate. Let them go because this person will only realize your value if you let them lose you. Let them go. Let them lose you. Move on. Chin up. And then build a new vibe. No hate, no drama. Just eat, sleep, relax, and repeat those patterns. Lift your spirit up. Do not follow up with this person. They will behave. Okay? The more you follow up, the more you chase, the more they will run away. If this person said something not nice to you, call them out diplomatically. Like for example, please be mindful of your words or tell them, I really like you, but please could you be consistent because I could offer you more than what you we could really be better. Like really put it out there because the Devil card, the Justice card, the reason why I'm saying that and suggesting that because they're the Emperor, it means that they can be managed. Like, this is a person who has a potential to be, because they're the emperor, it means that there's ego in them. And the more they can like overtake you, the more ego. But there's goodness in this person, the Justice card. In fact, I'm kind of picking up the universe. This person is a lover. Okay, this is a lover. This is definitely a lover. You have connected with this person. You have connected with this person in your past life. And in your past life, you were able to change this person. It's not your mission to change them, to tell them the way a person change. You can never change a person by, how do I do this? The person, you can only influence a person. And you can influence this person by behaving a high vibe. That's how you influence this person. If they said something nice to you, not nice to you, call them up diplomatically, like respectfully, please don't say that, or please be mindful of your words. Or if they're acting inconsistent, tell them exactly, look, I'm really interested with you, but I just don't like the fact that you're inconsistent. I don't know what your intention of me, but this is my intention and expectation. Put it out there, because they will be shocked. They will be shook. The Justice card, the Emperor, because they're the Emperor. It means that this person, they have capacity to give everything, all the goodness. They're like the Emperor. They're more than a king. You know, it means that they can really be mature and this and that, but they're acting immature right now. So to make this person act an emperor and not a devil is to challenge them. To challenge them by influencing them and telling them that, look, you're a nice person, or I know you can behave well. I don't know why you're behaving like that, but I'm sorry, you cannot be part of my energetic if you behave like it. Diplomatically, this person needs challenge. This person needs really diplomatically, respectfully, a good, nice, loving conversation that, hey, I really like you, but I don't like what you do. Or I really like you. Put it out there. I really like you. I'm interested with you. I really like you. I'm interested with you, but I just don't like that you're inconsistent and you say this or you say that. Please make up your mind. It will shock them, the Devil card. But it will make them commit. See? There are some ways for people to behave nice by not tolerating it, by putting it out there. Because the King of Pentacles, looking at the Emperor card, they will behave by calling them out diplomatically. They will drop, look at the Devil card, the Death card. They will drop the devil because they should be ashamed of themselves. They're the Emperor and behaving not nice to you. You call them out, you challenge them. It will change the game, okay? Respectfully. Listen to your intuition, because your intuition will tell you exactly what to say. In the whole zodiac, you are the one that can really install balance, even in the most devil situation. You are balance, Libra. That's one of your strengths, is balance. So you use your balance. You use your wisdom of balance. Do not chase. Do not be desperate. The more you're desperate, the more you chase. The more you chase, the more you're desperate. The more this person becomes an emperor, ego, conquer. You know, do not let them conquer you. You conquer them by balance, by wisdom, by speaking out the truth, the balance, calling their behavior diplomatically, because they're overacting. They're an emperor. They're overacting as an emperor. Their vibe is overacting emperor, which is ego, and that leads to the devil. Their potential. In fact, the reason why you're so attracted to this person, because you feel their potential, the passion inside of them. They should make use of their passion in a good way. And you can call them out. Address behavior. Okay? So, Libra, this is your reading. Thank you so much for connecting with me. Thank you so much for your support. Please don't forget to click the bell and click subscribe. And then what? Sunshine. Sorry. I'll upload the daily collective reading in the other in the other channel, okay? That will be about finance, career, and general inspirationship. Thank you so much, Libra. I read you faithfully. I follow your energy. I'll connect with you soon. You have a great day. Bye-bye.